We present a video of robotic partial nephrectomy for a right posterior hilar renal mass. Robotic partial nephrectomy has expanded the nephron-sparing approach to renal cell carcinoma. With increased utilization of robotic surgery, we have extended our indications for robotic nephron-sparing surgery to T2 tumors, solitary kidney lesions, and hilar masses. The patient is a 43-year-old female who initially presented with chest pain, having a history of mitral valve prolapse. A CT scan was performed as part of the workup, and an incidental renal mass was found. Of note, the patient is a diabetic and has had a previous history of laparoscopic cholecystectomy and C-sections times 2. Trocar placement is demonstrated with the camera port shifted laterally, with bariatric robotic trocars placed at least 8 centimeters apart to help minimize robotic arm collisions and maximize the working space for the bedside assistant. A 15mm and 5mm assistant port are placed in the midline midway between the umbilicus and xiphoid and infraumbilically to accommodate the ultrasound probe. In this patient with a posterior hilar mass, factors such as location relative to the hilum, inferior vena cava, ureter, and collecting system, posterior location, and size of the mass must be taken into consideration prior to initiating robotic partial nephrectomy. Using a monopolar scissor and fenestrated bipolar forceps, the line of tult is incised in an avascular plane to mobilize the bowel medially. This incision is extended beyond the superior pole of the kidney, as the kidney will ultimately need to be completely mobilized and flipped due to the posterior location of the tumor. The colorenal ligaments are divided, further mobilizing the colon to facilitate exposure to the renal hilum. A window is created between the lower pole and the psoas, and the kidney is elevated by the assistant using non-traumatic graspers. The ureter is isolated and elevated with the lower pole by the assistant, using caution not to devascularize the ureter with excessive dissection. Care is taken to identify the correct plane, as dissection too medially may result in an injury to the inferior vena cava, while too lateral and gyrotis fascia may be entered. The kidney is retracted anterior, putting the hilum on stretch to facilitate the dissection of the hilar vasculature. The medial aspect of the renal vein is identified and exposed using bipolar cautery of the overlying tissue. Transmitted pulsations from the renal artery are seen posterior to the renal vein. The Maryland forceps are spread parallel to the artery in order to isolate it for clamping without inadvertent avulsion of smaller branches or lumbar vessels. Sufficient length is achieved with the artery to accommodate 2 robotic bulldog clamps. The tissue posterior and lateral to the artery is also dissected to ensure good coaptation of the jaws of the bulldog clamps. Release of gyrotis fascia is then performed to expose the renal mass and allow for complete mobilization of the kidney. A mini lap is placed posterior to the upper pole to help maintain position, retraction, and exposure of the posterior mass. In preparation, the robotic bulldog clamps are placed in the abdomen on the perinephric fat for easy access and to minimize the reliance on the bedside assistant. Intraoperative robotic-controlled ultrasound is used to help localize the mass, as well as assess proximity to the collecting system and delineate surgical margins prior to extirpation. The renal capsule is scored circumferentially, creating a groove prior to excision of the mass. With this hilar mass, the plane between the tumor and sinus fat and renal pelvis is developed prior to hilar clamping. This can be safely performed off clamp and without ischemia until you encounter a small amount of bleeding. Once the margins are scored, 2 bulldog clamps are placed on the renal artery. In our experience, we leave the renal vein open and unclamped throughout the procedure, even with the hilar location of the tumor. The tumor is then resected using cold scissors circumferentially, with the assistant using the suction to give counter traction and keep the resection bed bloodless. Segmental arterial branches encountered during the resection are clipped with hemolock clips. A running 2-0 with a lapper tie on the end is used to close the collecting system and achieve hemostasis. In the case of the hilar tumor, it is important to be careful not to suture too deeply and incorporate and potentially constrict the renal pelvis. A double-arm 0-vicral suture is used to reconstruct the renal capsule using the sliding hemolock clip technique. Visual cues regarding the compression of the renal parenchyma are observed with dimpling of the surface of the capsule. The bulldog clamps are then removed and hemostasis is ensured. During this step, it is important that the patient's blood pressure is maintained at baseline preoperative levels by the anesthesiologist to assess the degree of bleeding. The specimen is then placed into an endocatch bag and the kidney is retroperitonealized. A drain is placed in the perinephric space at the end of the case. Postoperatively, the Foley catheter is removed on day 1, and the patient is advanced through a regular diet and typically discharged on postoperative day number 2. If the drain output is greater than 50 cc's, it is sent for creatinine. Hilar masses represent an expanding indication for robotic partial nephrectomy.